What's up, guys? Mike here, the Detroit Borg, with a quick look at what's new with a fourth beta of iOS 11, and some of the changes are significant. I think this is the most significant beta release yet. In terms of the fourth beta, the biggest news here is really the redesign to the notification center. So we're going to wake up the lock screen, and as you can see, when you wake it up, we get a different sort of animation. It sort of fades in from the bottom here. It's a little slower than I'd like to see, but perhaps we'll tweak that before we get to the final release. Big news here is the notification center here. So if I wake it up, you can see it swipes in from the bottom, which we're familiar with now, but there's a new way we interact with these notifications. So we can now swipe left to either view or clear that notification, or swipe right to open the notification. So let's go and swipe all the way right, and we also get a new animation for using our Touch ID sensor to open up the app, which requires a passcode. So if I tap my finger here, you can see it gives me that little animation and takes me right to the app. This also works with the iPad. Again, we get a slightly different wake-up screen, and then we can swipe on the notifications to act upon it. And then we can also just open it, and then we can use our fingerprint sensor to unlock directly to it. This also works with the notification shade. So for example, we can swipe left to open up view or clear. And if we swipe all the way left, this just clears out the notification. And then we can swipe right to open the notification. Once again, just to show you the new lock screen animation. Again, it's a little slower on iOS 11, but it's a slightly different effect. We also get some tweaks to the control center. So for example, when we enter low power mode by tapping this icon here, we get a slightly different animation. We also get a countdown timer with our screen recorder. So it counts down from 3 and begins recording. We also get redesigned icons for the Notes and Contacts app in addition to the Reminders app. I think the Contacts app is obviously the clearest change here. So we gain a gender, and it's an overall new design. They've also tweaked the Reminders icon. They've gone from 4 bullet points to 3 of them, and for some reason, it's backwards. That may change before the final release. And like a lot of things in iOS 11, they've also thickened the Wi-Fi bars, which makes it a little more visible. We also get some new splash screens highlighting some of the major new features for certain apps within iOS 11, such as the Notes app. So we have reference to the document camera, which I demonstrated in my iOS 11 walkthrough, but we also have Instant Notes, which I haven't tried before. But Instant Notes allows you to use the Notes app right on the lock screen without unlocking the device. So I'm just going to wake it up here, swipe up to the control center, tap the Notes button, and this will take me directly to the Notes app without having to authenticate. So the thing with Instant Notes is that it doesn't give you access to all of your previous notes without authenticating here. So again, if I go to my Instant Notes, I can't go back to all my notes without authenticating. Digging into the Photos app again, we have a splash screen for what's new in iOS 11 Photos, such as live photo editing, the new Memories album, and addition to live photo effects, which I've already demonstrated again in my previous video, which I'll leave linked in the description below. And of course, because the Podcast app was also redesigned, we also get a new splash screen for that as well. Now, if you remember from iOS 10, the AirDrop settings were actually built into the control center. So if you wanted to select different modes for AirDrop, you went right to it. But now it's under settings within iOS 11. You just have to go to general, and you'll see an AirDrop section right here with those same options. They've also tweaked the storage settings panel, so now it tells us how much storage this device originally had, 120 gigs. This used to tell us how much storage was used and how much was available. Also new in the App Store, you can pull to refresh to see if there's any new updates. Alrighty, so that's going to do for me in this quick look at the fourth beta of iOS 11. Of course, I'll keep you updated with any major changes before we see the final release later this fall. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up to let me know, and I'll see you again in my next video.